The avionics ring allows us to place the avionics like they would be in the real vehicle. So, you know, we have an engine section, we have all the shelves like the engine section, we have the cables routed like they would be on the real vehicle, we have an intertank section with the cables routed in there and the shelves all like that placement. We have all the avionics, 26 avionics boxes installed.
These are boxes that are just like the ones that will go on the rocket, but they are not the actual flight boxes. These will never fly on the actual rocket. We connect them into the system because it's the first time they've ever been integrated with other flight boxes, so we can see or determine how the rocket will actually fly. We can add winds, we can add rain, we can add all kinds of different things. We've got hundreds of models that we can introduce different environments, basically. And the models will tell us how something's going to work. We can actually go and tell one of the flight computers to shut down. How's a rocket going to run or fly with the other two?
As we designed this, we felt like we needed access to the flight computers, which are in the forward skirt. That was a common area that we needed to work on. So we inverted our vehicle. Forward skirt is on the bottom of our vehicle. Inner tank is in the middle. Engine compartment is all up on the upper section of it. So yeah, our rocket is flying upside down. The electronics don't really care. The only difference was how we route the system's tunnel cables.
It's nice that it's organized. Everyone knows what they're doing, really. And there's like a structure. So like, you know, one guy does this type of test. We have another guy that does this type of test. And it works out really well. Everyone works good with each other.
It's pretty huge. I mean, just the amount of like force and mass that you're lifting, that's pretty exciting for a mechanical engineer.
To know that we are actually building a rocket that could, in fact, make it to Mars is exciting. It's something that's never been done before. And I'm really proud to be working on a project for that.
I love it. It's like a dream come true, because when I was a little kid, I grew up in Central Florida, right near Kennedy Space Center. So we would see every rocket launch, every shuttle launch, and I always wanted to, you know, be one of the people that helps build the rocket or whatever. So here I am, and it's like the best feeling ever. I'm a mechanical engineer, and I grew up like building Legos my entire life, even little Lego rocket ships. So now I get to do it in real life.